हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्लास वी विल लर्न चैप्टर 15 आवर एनवायरनमेंट। इन क्लास 9 वी सो हाउ डिफरेंट मटेरियल्स आर साइकिल्ड इन द एनवायरनमेंट इन सेपरेट बायो जियोकेमिकल साइकिल्स। इन दिस साइकिल्स essential nutrients like nitrogen, carbon, oxygen and water are changed from one form to another. We shall now see how human activities affect these cycles. Biodegradable waste, substances that are broken down by the biological processes are said to be biodegradable. These substances are decomposed through the actions of bacteria or other saprophytes. Physical processes like heat and pressure also play an important role in the decomposition of biodegradable substances. For example, food waste, cow dung, etc. Non-biodegradable waste, substances that are not broken down by biological processes are said to be non-biodegradable. These substances are inert and simply persist in the environment for a longer time or may harm the various members of the ecosystem. For example, plastic, glass, etc. Ecosystem. All the interacting organisms in an area along with the non-living constituents of the environment form an ecosystem. An ecosystem consists of biotic components comprising of living organisms and abiotic components comprising of physical factors like temperature, rainfall, wind, soil and minerals. An ecosystem can be both natural or man-made. Some examples of natural ecosystems are grassland, forest, sea, river, etc. Man-made or artificial ecosystems are garden, aquarium, park, etc. Components of ecosystem. Biotic components. It includes three types of organisms: producers, consumers, and decomposers. Producers. All green plants and blue-green algae can produce their food from inorganic substances using light energy. So all green plants are called producers. They are also called autotrophs. Consumers. Consumers are organisms which consume other organisms or their products as their food. All animals belong to this category. The consumers depend upon producers for their food directly or indirectly. Consumers can be classified into the following types: herbivores, carnivores, parasites, and omnivores. Herbivores. Herbivores are organisms which get their food by eating the producers directly. They are also called first order consumers. Some common examples are deer, rabbit, cow, etc. Carnivores. Carnivores are organisms which consume other animals. They are also called second order consumers or third order consumers. The carnivores which are not preyed upon further are called top carnivores. For example, lion is a top carnivore. Omnivores. The organisms which feed on both plants and animals are called omnivores. Example, human beings. Decomposers. Microorganisms like fungi and bacteria break down the dead plants and animals. They are called decomposers as they break down complex organic compounds into the simple inorganic substances. The decomposers help in the replenishment of natural resources. Food chain. the sequence of living organism in a community in which one organism consumes other organism to transfer food energy is called a food chain. Trophic levels. Each step or level of food chain is called trophic level. The autotrophs or producers are at the first trophic level. The herbivores or primary consumers form the second trophic level. Small carnivores or secondary consumers form the third trophic level. Large carnivores or tertiary consumers form the fourth trophic level. Flow of energy in a food chain. Green plants capture 1% of sunlight and convert it into food energy. Only 10% of energy is transferred to the next trophic level. The remaining 90% energy is used in life processes like digestion, growth, reproduction, etc. by present trophic level. As only 10% of energy at each trophic level is transferred to the next, food chain generally have only 3 to 4 trophic levels. The number of organisms gradually decreases from one trophic level to another. Food chain link with each other to form food web. The flow of energy is unidirectional in a food chain. The energy that is captured by the autotrophs does not revert back to the solar input, and the energy which passes to the herbivores does not come back to the autotrophs. As it moves progressively through the various trophic levels, it is no longer available to the previous level. Biological magnification. We use several pesticides and chemicals to protect our crops from diseases and pests. The pesticides and chemicals are absorbed by the plants from soil and enter the food chain. As humans occupy the top level of any food chain, a maximum concentration of chemicals is found in our bodies. This is called biological magnification. Ozone. Ozone is a molecule formed by 3 atoms of oxygen. At ground level, ozone is a deadly poison. Formation of ozone molecule. Ozone at higher levels of the atmosphere is a product of ultraviolet rays acting on oxygen molecule. The high energy ultraviolet radiations split apart some molecular oxygen into free oxygen. These atoms then combine with molecular oxygen to form ozone. Ozone layer. At higher level of atmosphere, ozone performs an essential function. It shields the earth from UV radiations from the sun, thus protecting the living beings from health hazards like skin cancer, cataract in eyes, weakened immune system, etc. Depletion of ozone layer. The decrease in the thickness of ozone layer over Antarctica was first observed in 1985 and was termed as ozone hole. This decrease was linked to excessive use of synthetic chemicals like chlorofluorocarbon, which are used in refrigerators, ACs, fire extinguishers, aerosols, sprays, etc. United Nations Environment Programme (UNEP) succeeded in forging an agreement to stop CFC production at 1986 levels by all countries. Garbage disposal. Industrialization and rise in demand of consumer goods have created a major problem in the form of garbage waste accumulation and its disposal, especially in urban areas. The different methods of waste disposal commonly used are open dumping, a conventional method in which solid waste are dumped in selected areas of a town. Landfillings. Waste are dumped in low living area and are compacted by rolling with bulldozers. Composting. Organic waste are filled into a compost pit. It is then covered with a layer of soil. After about 3 months, the garbage filled inside the pit changes into organic manure. Recycling. The solid waste is broken down into its constituent similar materials. These materials are then used to make new items. Solid waste like plastic, metal, etc. can be recycled. Reuse, a very simple conventional method of using an item again and again. For example, a paper can be used for making envelopes. Home assignment. Complete all the exercises of chapter 15. Thank you.